Hello everyone and welcome to another edition of New Tech Tuesday Tutorials. My name is Richard Evans. Make sure you like, comment, and subscribe to this video. Today I want to show you how to trigger a macro using a macro. Macros are ways for you to record various actions on the TriCaster and then play those actions back in real time. For example, bringing on a lower third and then having it fade off 10 seconds later. You can do that by hand or just use a macro to make it easy and repeatable. But you can also have another macro trigger a macro, minimizing the amount of commands you have to execute inside each macro that you build. An object-oriented way of programming your TriCaster. Now I'm going to show you a very simple explanation today of how to do this. So let's take a look and show you how it's done, son. All right, so here we are in the TriCaster TC1 interface. And before I get into the macro side of things, let me show you what I want to accomplish here. So I have my live graphic set up in buffer number 3. And let me go ahead and bring that on screen, which is assigned to my downstream key or number 3. And just click cut. And now you see that I have my live graphic on screen. And if I open up the settings for buffer number 3, you'll see that I have a couple different things that I can do here. I can trigger the graphic to come on and off screen simply by clicking on these different presets. So there it is coming off and then coming back on. And then I have data presets in here for the different titles that I want to display. So for the first one here, I have title number 1. If I click on that, you'll see that my text field changes over here. And if I click on title 2, text changes there. And if I click on preset number 3, title goes away because it says empty. Okay, so let me go ahead and take that off screen for the time being. You'll notice that my downstream key 3 is still on, which means that I just basically have that on screen ready for my graphic to be triggered by the macros that we're about to create here. All right, so let's start to do that. I'm going to go to, let me close this window real quick. I'll go to the top of the screen, go to macros, configure macros, and I'll stay in my session macros here. And so the first macro that I want to create is just, I'm going to title this one lower third macro. Count how many times I say the word macro today. Okay, so what I want this to do is I'm going to hit record and then carry out the action of bringing that lower third graphic on screen for a few seconds and then have it animate off screen. So let's go ahead and click record. So now we're recording and I'll go to buffer number 3 and I'm going to click on the layer preset number 2, which brings it on screen. So there it is, ta-da. And then I'm still recording and then I'm going to click layer preset 12 to bring that off screen. And whoop, there it goes, animates away, awesome. All right, and let me stop the recording of that and let's go back into this lower third macro, and I'm going to click edit here to show you what the text looks like inside of that macro. So the first option you'll see, it says buffer 3 title select animation preset, and that preset is value 2, which brought it on screen. And then the second one is selecting preset 12, which brings it off screen. And it looks like it took me about 293 frames to do that action. So let's just go ahead and type in with my keyboard 300 frames. So just make it a nice little round number. All right, so now we have my lower third macro ready to go. And if I hit play on that, check it out. It will bring up that preset. And then in 300 frames, it will animate that off screen. Whoop, there it goes. Cool. Okay, so very simple. Again, you can make these macros as complicated as you want. But for today's example, I want to keep this very, very minimal here. So let me go ahead and bring that back on screen real quick so I can show you some of my data presets. So again, like I said, I have my data presets for title 1, title 2, and empty here. So now I want to make another macro which will start to trigger my data presets. So let's go ahead and close that and I'll go back into my macro configuration and start a new macro and let's just say title 1. Keep this very simple. Okay, so now I'm gonna do the same thing here. I'm gonna hit record. Actually, first let me take it off screen so that you can see that it does something. All right, so I'm gonna hit record on my macro, and then I'm going to select my data preset number 1. There we go, cool. and let's stop the recording on that. And let me open up this particular macro and show you what the text looks like in there. So this just says buffer three titles select data preset, and that preset is value number one. All right, so now what I'm gonna do is I'm going to clone this macro by right-clicking on it and selecting clone. And let's rename it title two. Okay, now I'm going to open up that macro. So instead of having me go through and record that action again, I'm just gonna click edit. And then instead of preset number one, let's just add the value two here. So that will bring up data preset number two. All right, so let's go ahead and hit play. And when I do that, boom, you'll see title number two changes. All right, pretty dang cool so far. All right, so now what I wanna do is I want to have these particular macros, title one and title two, I want those to then recall that lower third macro that I've created earlier. So I'll do that by clicking edit. And then for the shortcut, this is the shortcut you're gonna need to use to do this. We'll do macro, so I'm sorry, back that up. Play underscore macro underscore by name. All right, now from here in the value side of things, this is where we're gonna type in the name of the macro that we want to trigger on this particular example. Now it is case sensitive, so just keep that in mind. So lower third macro. All right, so now all that is going to do is it's going to change the data preset and then play that macro that I had earlier, which brings that graphic on screen for 300 frames and then takes it off screen. All right, and let me go ahead and bring this preset off screen first so that you can see how that works. Okay, so I'm not gonna touch this lower third macro. That one's good to go, that's gonna be universal. All right, so let's go ahead and hit play on title one and check it out. So it brings up the graphic and has title one in there. All right, and then you'll see in 300 frames that will go away. Bam, there it goes. All right, so now I'm gonna go back into title one macro and I'm gonna copy this particular line by clicking copy here. And let's go into title two and then we'll paste that information in there. Cool, so that's all we have to do. So now, basically what's happening is title one will change the data preset and then fire off the lower third macro, which brings up the graphic. And title two does the same thing, but changes the data preset on that one as well. All right, so let me go back in here and bring it on screen and clear it all out. So you'll see that it is currently empty. And now, let's take it off screen again so we can kind of put this back to normal. And now let's click on title one macro and check it out. So now it will bring up that graphic and the text and then it will fade it off. Bloop, there we go. And then we'll do the same thing on title two. I'll hit play on that and there we go, yeah, yeah. And then 300 frames, that will fade off screen as well. And there it goes. Cool, now what's awesome about this, now that I have these two macros pointing to that first macro, if I wanna make a change in that macro, all I have to do now is just change lower third macro itself. So for example, now, instead of making it 300 frames, let's make it 400 frames. All right, now I don't have to go through and do anything on these two macros because they're pointing to that lower third macro. So let's go ahead and hit play on this first one here. There it goes, it brings up my titles. And now instead of 300 frames, it'll fade off in 400 frames. And my hands aren't even touching my TriCaster keyboard and mouse, nothing. Just does it all automatically. That's pretty dang cool. So that way you can start to go through and customize things using some object-oriented programming and start to point to different macros to do these. So I could load these up and just clone these all day with different data presets and just have it recall that first lower third macro and I don't have to do anything on it. Or if I wanted to change the speed of it, just change the original lower third macro. Dust your hands and have a great broadcast. So as you can see, having macros trigger other macros is another great way to simplify your production and make it easier on the TriCaster operator to run a show. To find more tutorial videos like this one, head over to the NewTek YouTube page at youtube.com/NewTekInc and click on that subscribe button. You can also find out more about NewTek products and services by contacting your local reseller, or you can visit our website, newtek.com. Also, be sure to check out newtek.tv, where we will be featuring NewTek product demonstrations and announcements, along with interviews with NewTek users, third-party developers, and a lot more. And if you're posting your work on social media, tag us using the hashtags NewTek or TriCaster. We love to see what our NewTek users are creating. That about wraps it up, so thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you next time on another edition of what? NewTek Tuesday Tutorials.